to welcome you, and those who of you who've been here before, we're glad to see you back from the Wild North, and for those who haven't been here, we hope you enjoy it very much. The obligatory items are that the restrooms are over here on your left. The exits are back there and through the exit door here if there should be a reason you need to leave quickly. I would like to say there's also one other obligatory item I'd like to talk about, and that is that this is a totally volunteer company that does all of this, and that we are dependent very much on the donations and the goodwill of our audiences. Currently, for example, we are paying off an equity loan that took care of our roof and air conditioning, and we've got half of the loan on the digital equipment in the cinema, which helps support our playtime over here. But now it's almost Christmas time, and we decided to take a look at how Christmas is celebrated in the little tiny towns, particularly the town of Tuna, Texas. And please join us there, and I hope you are entertained.
KKK in Tuna, Texas, serving the greater Tuna area at 275 watts, signing on.
Merry Christmas, Tuna. This is Thurston Wheelis.
And this is Arliss Struvey.
And this is the Wheelis
Struvey Happy Holiday Report.
First off in the news, we have the finalists in the OKKK Christmas Yard Display Contest. We've been waiting on this one.
We have.
Leading that competition as usual is the display at the home of W.H. and Vera Karp. The Karp's yard display is titled the Christmas Hall of Fame and consists of a traditional nativity scene complete with live sheep. Where the Holy Family is made out of hard plastic and lit from the inside and is surrounded not only by the wise men and shepherds, but the crowd also includes Santa Claus, Bing Crosby, the Grinch Who Stole Christmas, and Natalie Wood. Still in the running is Dee Dee Snavely's gigantic Christmas tree made out of aluminum pie pans and colored floodlights titled, Oh, What a Heavenly Light.
Well, you can see it as far off as Dewey County.
It draws bugs in December.
It does.
It does.
It does, it does.
Oh, the heat puts out is something awful. Still in the thick of things is the controversial entry over at the duplex of Anita Goodwin and Helen Bed. That entry is titled All I Want for Christmas and consists of two life-size cowboy mannequins stuffed into huge Christmas stockings and hung off the front porch balcony. A lot of folks were upset by that one.
Hell, Sheriff Givens tried to arrest Anita and Helen.
Thought he had a double homicide.
He did. Next up, the local chapter of the Smut Snatchers of the New Order is offering a $50 reward as well as an autographed copy of Reverend Spike's new book, Cleaned Up Deuteronomy. For any information leading to the arrest of the infamous Christmas Phantom who has wreaked havoc in the greater Tuna area for years. Now, it seems the Phantom struck again last night and loosened all the lights on the community Christmas tree and just ruined the big moment before Garlinda Crump was to sing, Oh Holy Night.
She's still not over the hurt.
She's not. So if you have any information, give Vera Karp a call over at the Smut Snatchers. She's running the organization until Reverend Spikes gets out of prison. And now on a somber note, Coweta Baptist Church, in conjunction with the Dropback and Punk Club, is holding a 24-hour prayer vigil for head football coach Raymond Chassie as he tries for the third time to pass the Texas State Teacher Competency Exam. If he flunks it again, this time he's going into politics, so get out there to that Coweta church and pray, pray, pray.
Hey, Wallace, you never know what you got till it's gone.
You don't.
You don't.
You don't. You don't. We'll have more on that story as it develops, but right now it's time for the public opinion section of our show, Tuna Speaks. And today's concerned citizen is none other than Tuna's own Elmer Watkins. Elmer!
This is Elmer Watkins for Clan 249, inviting all of you to our annual Christmas family night and skeet shoot. Now, the theme of this year's family night is the whitest Christmas ever, and will consist of fun and education for the whole family. Wear something white and receive a free raffle ticket for our door prize, a butane-powered flamethrower. After last year, I feel I must remind you of our new rule prohibiting flammable liquids where women and children are present. I feel very personal about this. You would, too, if all of your eyebrows had been burned off and never grew back. That's why I wear my cap so low. It's embarrassing. This is Elmer Watkins for Clan 249 saying season's greetings.
Well, thank you, Elmer. And I tell you, folks, it is such a joy to be here in the greater Tuna area when that Christmas spirit starts to take a hold. It is.
It is.
It is, it is.
I get all choked up.
Well, you've always been emotional.
I have.
He has. Next up, the local theater is giving a production of A Christmas Carol by Charlie Dickens. Now, Joe Bob Lipsey is the director, and Joe Bob, as you know, has become a local legend for his innovative staging techniques, which gave us the unforgettable Greek tragedy of Medea, set in Yazoo City, Mississippi, in which Medea's husband dumps her for a waitress from Cincinnati, forcing her to strangle her two kids rather than let them grow up with a Yankee stepmother.
Well, that Joe Bob is a creative fella.
He is.
He is.
He is. Christmas Carol will be a traditional staging, according to Lipsy, who says that all financial contributions will be chipped in to pay for the theater's overdue electric bill. But City Secretary Dixie DeBerry says if they don't pay up by Christmas Eve, they'll be singing in the dark.
Well, you know what it is, Arliss. Dixie's still mad at Joe Bob for last year's musical when he said she was too old to play Mame.
Well, hell, she's older than water.
She is.
She is about half mean, too. Do you remember when she cut off the lights at the homecoming game just before halftime?
And that little twirler had her baton 30 feet up in the air.
She did.
She did.
She did. She did. It caught her right below the eye. Thurston, you got that farm report?
Well, it's around here somewhere. I don't know where the damn thing is. Ronnie! Well, I hate when I have to make it up. I know cantaloupes were higher than a city skirt the other day, and there's something we're not supposed to be eating. Oh, hell, here it is. Let's see. Well, beef unchanged, pork unstable, chickens uneventful. There's not a thing on here about sow bellies, so let's go to a commercial from our sponsor, Dee Dee Snavely of Dee Dee's Used Weapons. Merry Christmas!
And a holly jolly Christmas to you too, Thurston. Folks, this is Dee Dee Snavely asking, do you know how dangerous it can be in this day and age to go out riding unarmed in a one-horse open sleigh? Well, lay your fears to rest, because here at Dee Dee's we are stocked to the ceiling with weaponry for the home, the auto, and the workplace.
Now, God forbid anyone listening should become the victim of a Christmas theft. But wouldn't you rather shoot someone than watch them run off with your new toaster? I know I would. So whether it's a stun gun, judo clubs, or just a plain old-fashioned switchblade, you come by the Davies and you'll have a holla jolly Christmas, and the criminal will have a silent night.
Thank you, Dee Dee. Now, folks, if you can't be with your loved ones, or if your family's just driving you right up a wall, why don't you consider coming down to the OKKK Christmas party and covered dish supper?
I have gone every year since Trudy and I got divorced, and I've never had a better Christmas.
You know, I kind of miss old Trudy.
Oh, me too.
Where's your Christmas spirit?
Don't get me going. Trudy and I got divorced because of Christmas.
That's right, I forgot.
She wanted a set of Japanese steak knives, and I got her a heating pad instead.
That's when she went and poured all that grapefruit juice in your punch.
She sure as hell did, and she knew I was allergic to grapefruit juice when she sneaked into that kitchen and poured God knows how much of it into the punch.
I remember it made you itch.
Itch? Hell, I scratched the heart the doctor made me wear mittens. I still had them on in divorce court.
He did.
I did. Well, Trudy, if you can hear my voice, you're too close. Yeah, you're too close, all right. And finally, from our world news desk, the Christmas violence continues with no end in sight, leaving thousands homeless in the city of Hell, I can't even pronounce the name of this place.
Must be far off.
Must be, well, folks, they must be foreigners, so never mind.
Never mind. This is Thurston Willis.
And this is Arliss Drewby saying happy holidays. Each of you looking for Christmas pets not to succumb to that urge to acquire an exotic animal, because after a few weeks the new wears off and I end up with it. Now you may think it's cute to teach that minor bird barroom language, but when your fundamentalist relatives come to visit and that bird wakes them up at the crack of dawn cussing the blue streak, what do? You give it to me. That baby alligator sure is a family favorite when it's no bigger than your finger. But 10 months later, when it hisses at your sister-in-law and tries to mate with your luggage, what do? You give it to me. Exotic pets have mean streaks, and I've got the stitches to prove it. Skunks or moody raccoons are self-centered, and wild hogs have a zero success rate as yard pets. To say no to that wild animal is nothing else. It'll cut down on your doctor bills. Like my grandma used to say, you just give nature a little space, and it won't try to kill you. This is Petey Fist speaking to you for the Greater Tuna Humane Society. Thank you.
Pretty.
This is Leonard Childers speaking to you on radio station OKKK. And welcoming you to Leonard's Let the Stops Out radio shopping spree. Remember, if you can't find it on Leonard's, you're too picky. So I encourage all of you to call in and buy something.
Kitty, 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 where did you come from? How did you get in this house? What is wrong with you? No, don't go up there. Jody!
What?
Get yourself down here pronto. No, don't go in there. Jody!
What?
Get down here now. No, not the tree. Don't go for the tree. No, cat. Get it. Oh.
Well, I guess you found the cat.
Is that what it is? I want it out of here now.
Oh, Mama, she's gonna have babies.
Not here, she's not. And I don't have to ask where you got it. Only Petey Fitz would dump a pregnant cat on me at Christmas time.
Well, she doesn't have any place else to go, Mama. Well, Petey said all this cat needs is a warm blanket and some straw, just like in the manger.
Jody, I am not playing midwife to a pregnant cat. I have too much to do today. I have a Smut Snatchers meeting at noon. I have to bake a Frito pie for the radio station party. I have to finish decorating these clown cookies. I'm supposed to be at Coach Chass's prayer vigil. Your father hasn't called, and Stanley gets off probation, and everybody thinks he's the Christmas Phantom.
Well, I know who the Phantom is.
And when your sister finds out we have a cat, she'll have one herself. You know Charlene's allergic to cats.
Well, maybe she'll pass out. We won't have to listen to her squawk.
That cat is going back to Petey Fisk today. Stanley Jean, Charlene Renee, get down here now. I'm putting on the Andy Williams album.
Oh, Mama, last year you promised not to play that record again.
Honey, your father promised not to miss another Christmas. Hitler promised to stop after Czechoslovakia. Hello. Oh, Merry Christmas, Aunt Pearl. No, Hank's not here. I think he's caught in that snowstorm out in Amarillo. Well, it's supposed to snow out there sometime. No, Stanley's not up yet, but he should be. All right, Aunt Pearl, I'll send him over, but I don't want Stanley out in the public view too much today, not with this phantom business going on. Sometimes I wish Stanley would just up and leave town. All right, and tell Uncle Henry I'll be back tomorrow with his chocolate-covered cherries. No, I don't trust Charlene after last year. I removed the pits myself. Yes, I know. It's a good thing you do the Heimlich maneuver. All right, Aunt Pearl, I love you too. Bye.
Opening night, and you were the most brilliant director who'd ever lived. So don't knock Joe Bob, Mother. He's the only sensitive person in this hole in the road, and if he moves back to Lubbock, I'll kill myself so there.
Charlene, Baptists do not kill themselves.
I'll start a new trend.
Honey, how's play practice?
Awful, thanks to you and those goofy old Smut Snatchers. Who ever heard of a dirty word in a Christmas carol?
Well, Vera Karp says they're there. And Charlene, the Smut Snatchers are here for the protection of everyone. Censorship is as American as apple pie, so shut up! Now, honey, I want you to stay around the house today. I want to take pictures of everybody, the whole family, and put it on Christmas cards next year, if I can get your daddy to sit still long enough for one.
Well, I know what. Next time he passes out drunk in front of the TV set, let's just gather around the couch and take a picture of that.
Sure.
I mean, won't that look lovely on a Christmas card?
Charlene, don't make me slap you this near Christmas. Now, come on, honey, help me decorate the tree. It'll be fun.
Ooh, it's a sick tree. Connie Carp's tree touches the ceiling and has plastic icicles that look like real eyes.
Connie Carp's parents have more money than we do. Charlene, don't throw the icicles. Oh, look, honey. Hang this up. Do you remember when you made this little angel?
I never made that. You say that every year.
Well, I'm gonna go hang it up next to Stanley's license plate. Do you remember when he made that in reform school? I wish you would help me decorate the tree. It's no fun doing this by yourself.
You know... wonder why Joe Bob's never been married.
Well, honey, I don't think Joe Bob's the marrying kind.
Why?
Well, Joe Bob's always been different.
Well, what is that supposed to mean?
It just means he's out of the ordinary.
You are so cruel.
Now, Charlene, you know I like Joe Bob. Come and help me decorate the tree, honey.
I don't want to. And besides, I can't afford to waste my artistic integrity on that pathetic little shrub.
Charlene, you have 5 seconds to get in the Christmas spirit before I hair-lip you.
Right, Mother. Happy, happy, happy.
Don't throw the icicle, Charlene. You get that meanness from your daddy. I wish you wouldn't be so mean like that.
And speaking of mean, will you please ask Stanley to rent out the tub when he's through? I get totally grossed out every morning.
You be nice to your brother. He has a lot on his mind.
That's impossible.
Today is his last probation hearing, and that's a Christmas blessing.
It would be a blessing if he was back in jail.
He's nervous enough about that part he has to play in the Christmas carol.
I don't know why. He just stands there staring like he's in a lineup. Everybody knows he's the Christmas Phantom. It's just a matter of time before he's back in prison.
He was in reform school. Your daddy was in prison. And the part that he has to play is the last of his community service. Charlene, you need to show your twin brother support.
It would be a community service if he left town.
Stanley's not going anywhere.
That's not what I hear.
And where are you going?
I'm not to tell you everything, Mother.
Well, fine, young lady. You stay gone all day, and I'll lock you out with the dogs, and you can get Joe Bob Lipsy to feed you.
Well, thank you, Joan Crawford.
Hello. Oh, hello, Matt. Thanks for calling back. Yeah, well, you may not want to wish me a Merry Christmas when you hear what I have to say, I. Yeah, well, listen, I want you to have my husband call his home. You don't know where he is. Well, I suggest you get up off your Christmas butt, finish your Christmas brew, and go and find him. Oh, I think you'll find him, Matt, because if you don't, the next message I leave will be with your wife, Ida. You do remember Ida, don't you? And I'll be telling her about that red-headed bank teller that you and Leonard and my husband and half the men in this town go play poker with over in Sand City. Now, I'm already mad I had to leave a message at this nasty beer joint you're in. And I'm spraying down this phone with Lysol when I hang up. And if I don't hear from my husband by this afternoon, I'm cashing in his poker chips and yours. Now, you try and have a merry one. I'm a desperate woman. Stanley Jean, get down here now. Except your father, so stop complaining. Charlene's bad enough, and Jody's in the pantry with a mean and pregnant pussycat ready to bingo at any minute. Santa Claus walked through this door right now, I'd set his beard on fire.
Now that is just what we need, is a cat. A moody little foul-tempered thing with claws that sheds. Hell, we've got that with Charlene.
Stanley, I'm slamming your sister.
Actually, a cat's a step up.
Did you get her anything for Christmas?
Nope, they were all out of sheep dip.
Well, I went ahead and got her something for you. And Stanley, I hope nobody we know is involved in this Christmas phantom business.
I have been at play practice. Every time the phantom is struck, so just get off. I've got an airtight alibi.
That's what worries me.
You know, you're just like everybody else in this whole town. I'm so nice to everybody, and they all just treat me like shit.
Stanley, damn it, don't cuss on Christmas. Now, Stanley, I don't want to argue with you. I do enough of that with your father. Let's try and have a decent Christmas. This is your gift for Charlene. It's that new perfume called Compromise. I want you to wrap it up and put it under the tree.
Oh, great, Mama. What were you thinking? Have you smelled the bathroom lately?
Well, I can't do anything right.
It's okay, I'll wrap it up. I'll wrap it up. She lays it on like a crop duster, though. Say, Mama, what do you want for Christmas?
Your father here.
Yeah, well, what's your second choice?
He might show up. Don't eat the eyes off those clown cookies. They're for the MYF.
When did we turn Methodist?
We didn't. I'm just trying to make some extra spending money. And your Aunt Pearl called. She wants you to come by something about a blue jay and her banty rooster.
Are they going at it again?
Don't drink out of the carton. And Stanley, don't go to your last probation hearing looking like a zombie. Wear a shirt and tie.
I don't own the top.
Now come here.
Why?
Just come over here. I want you to hold this.
Oh, I remember when I made that back when I was little. Damn, Mom! I wish you'd warn me before you do that.
Well, at least I'll have one good picture of you at Christmas time. Don't you want to stay here and have to put the tinsel on the tree, Stanley?
Looks like Charlene's already done that.
Well, don't you want to be here when we put the star on the tree?
Take a picture.
Take a picture. Take a picture. What has happened to this family? Used to be so simple. Now I can't even get my family together for a picture. I know the good Lord has other plans for us, but sometimes I think I deserve a little peace on earth. Display.
Hang on. Lupe, Lupe, darling, hang that on a lower branch. Valhalla, Lupe, bring it down. Valhalla. Are you there?
Yes, Vera.
Well, I suppose your Stanley can't be the Phantom because he's been at play practice with Virgil, so apparently he has an alibi. Mm. But if he does turn out to be the Phantom, I pray they don't put him in jail till after Christmas. You've been through so much already. How do you hold up?
I'm used to it.
Oh, and about Stanley's probation, I baked him a cake. But if he messes up before the hearing, we'll just freeze it and have it when he gets out of jail.
You've always been thoughtful, Vera.
Oh, it's nothing. We have those super ply freezer bags. I don't remember the name. Lupe? Lupe, darling, where are our freezer bags, por favor? Freezer bags? Freezer bags? Oh, never mind. Lord, sometimes I swear it's like a scene from the miracle worker around here. Oh, I just remembered why I called you. I know what's wrong with your Christmas tree.
What?
Well, put on a pot of coffee and I'll run right over and show you.
Vera, you
know. Oh, it's no trouble. It's just right across the street. I'll be right there.
Vera! Lord, this Christmas is gonna take 10 years off me. I've got one child in the pantry with a mean pregnant cat, another one with one foot in jail, and Charlene's in love with a sissy. I wish Joe Bob would go back to Corpus or Beaumont or wherever it is he goes and take his movie posters and his soundtracks with him. I hear Bally High one more time, I'm throwing Charlene right out of the house. Now Vera Carp wants to come over and redecorate my Christmas tree.
Knock, knock.
Come in, Vera.
Oh, you have such a lovely view of my yard display from here.
Yes, we do.
What's wrong with this tree?
What?
You need to turn the back side to the wall.
We did.
Oh. Well, I know what. I'll give you all of our old ornaments, and you can use them to fill in those bare spaces. I gave them to Lupe, but I'll make her bring them back. She really doesn't appreciate nice things.
Well, Vera, have you finished your dirty word list for a Christmas carol?
Well, of course I have. I'm head of the obscene committee, remember?
What's the verdict?
Well, merry gentlemen have to go.
Merry gentlemen? Why?
Oh, Bertha, you know those people talk in codes.
Oh, yeah.
And there has been just a storm of controversy about round young virgins.
Vera, that's round yon virgin.
Well, it's too late, they're already out. I'm not comfortable singing about virgins in any case. We'll leave that to the Catholics. Well, I am just an overheated downhill wreck about that yard display contest. If we win again, we will retire the trophy.
I know how much that would mean to you, Vera.
That trophy is so lovely. And it would mean so much to me personally to win 15 years in a row. Hold on. Virgil, leave the sheep alone and it won't bite. You know, they say that sheep aren't aggressive, but all three of these in the yard display have bitten Virgil.
Well, I guess they've had enough.
Well, I know how they feel. I have tried everything to keep him out of that yard display. Barbed wire, baling wire. Dee Dee Snavely tried to sell me that stuff they used down the Mexican border. Hold on. Virgil, don't grab the sheep there. That's why he charges.
Vera, you should have him seen to.
We'll have him sheared and slaughtered for New Year's. Oh, and as for Virgil, well, he's off to military school in No Hope, Arizona, and I pray they can do something with him.
Well, Vera, I'm expecting Hank at any minute.
Well, you could just be waiting all day. Virgil, stop chucking rocks at the Holy Family. Drop that gravel. Behave now.
Well,
Deberry will shut off the lights at the community theater.
Well, if they don't pay their bill, I'm sure she will.
It would be such a shame for them to have done all that work and then have it not happen. WH and I would ordinarily pay the bill, but Lord, times are hard. We could barely afford new cars this year.
Hold on, he's got the baby. Virgil, put that baby down. That baby is wired with electricity.
I don't know how he got that baby out. I paid Julio minimum wage to glue that baby into that manger. Let me call you later.
Vera, good luck with the contest. Well, it's just you and me, Tree. Charlene's throwing icicles all over the place. Let's see if we can fix you up a little bit. That's gotta look a little bit better. Lord, I hope I can just make it through this day. Shut up, Wolfie. Get down. Get down. Come in, Arliss. I think that just means he likes you.
Well, if he likes any better, we'd have to get married. That's a cute little dog you got there, Bertha.
Well, Chiquita's a little hyper.
Oh, we had one just like it when I was a kid. Little ping pong ball head, marble eyes. It shook a lot. We took it on vacation one time to Yellowstone, and a hawk got it in the first 10 minutes.
Oh, Arliss, that's terrible. Would you like some coffee?
Well, actually, I came by to see Hank. Somebody turned in his wallet down at the radio station.
Where did they find it?
Well, I can't say as I recall.
Well, you can tell me, Arliss. I'm used to Hank.
Well, as I recall, it was in a parking lot.
The parking lot of the Starlight Motel, wasn't it?
Yeah, Bertha, as I recall it was. I'm sorry.
Well, I appreciate you bringing it by.
You know, if it makes you feel any better, I know how you feel. Trudy came home one time wearing Fruit of the Looms. Well, I gotta run. I got a lot of stuff to do before the party at the radio station tonight. Say, why don't you come down to the party if you feel like it?
I just might do that, Arliss.
Merry Christmas, Bertha.
Merry Christmas, Arliss. Christmas used to be so simple. Well, not always. There was that time that Hank was in prison. I was working at the Tasty Cream cooking on Christmas Eve. And that bread man from Odessa wanted me to run away with him. He'd been drinking, I know it, but I know he meant it. Where would you be now, Bertha? Well, I wouldn't have my babies, and I wouldn't give that up for anything.
Mama! Mama!
Oh, not now, Cat. Calm down, Miss Kitty. Nobody's gonna harm you. Jody, reach up there and get that box down from that top shelf. Hurry, honey, we're gonna need it.
Out of cold.
dud grenades. I need a few more to finish trimming out the tree.
Last time I saw them, your mama was going through them in the powder room.
Where?
The powder room.
The powder room? God! Damn it, R.R. How many times have I told you about that gunpowder?
You said they was duds.
Poor mama's confused. She thinks they're pineapples sent out from California by Dottie and Clyde. Well, don't just stand there like a government employee. Get into that powder room and find them grenades. God, I'm not even comfortable smoking in there. I live in fear that mama's gonna walk into the kitchen to fix a fruit salad and blow us all the way to Tierra del Fuego. Hey! Hey! Make sure you sweep up whatever you spilled in there, R.R. I thought when the sky turned black on my wedding day that it was just Texas weather. Mama swore it was an omen, but I wouldn't listen. Oh, well, it's too late now. Hey, bell ring. Are you listening? In the lane. Glistening. We're happy tonight. Well, come on in, Pearl.
Merry Christmas, Dee
Dee. Now, Pearl, I've been meaning to call you. Why didn't you do a yard display this year?
Well, I'm throwing in the towel. Vera Carp wouldn't let go of that trophy if you sprayed her with mustard gas.
Well, maybe she will and maybe she won't. That giant Christmas tree of mine out there is going to be pretty hard to top, but I really thought you had a contender last year with your Christmas at Colonel Sanders.
Well, it took too long to get all those chickens in their little elf costumes. Now, Dee Dee, I'm here looking for a gun.
Well, I thought you had a gun, Pearl.
Well, I did, but I threw it away after I shot my second husband.
Was that the sleepwalker?
Well, he should have told me that. Now, Dee Dee, I need something to kill blue jays with.
Pearl, have I got the gun for you. Now, this here is a Canadian hummingbird derringer. It's light, easy to handle. It'll fit in your purse, and it will knock the fuzz off a gnat's ass at 35 yards.
I don't know, Dee Dee. The gun might be too loud. My hens won't lay.
No problem. R.R., see if we have any poison bird seed back there.
Oh, no. I stopped using poison bird seed after I killed Henry's bird dog with it last year.
Never mind, R.R., but make me some hot chocolate while you're back there. Try not to scald the milk. Pitiful. Now, let me think. I guess the only thing left is the good old-fashioned slingshot and ball-bearing routine.
That's a good idea, and I've got all those marbles that I bought when Bertha's kids were young. I still got them, though.
Now, that's smart, Pearl. One person's clutter can be another person's weapon. My mama always taught me that.
How is your mama? Dee Dee, is Mimi doing better? Dixie said she tried to cut all her hair off.
She did. Poor mama's just going downhill every day. Nearly gassed us twice last week. Twice! Tried to fry Rice Krispies the other day. We're looking for a home for her now. I tell you, it just damn near killed me. And this morning she hops out of bed and claims she's the Christmas fan.
Oh, you've got to find her a home quick.
Hell, it gets worse. She claims that you and Dixie Deberry put her up to it.
Oh, no.
I tell you, Pearl, the mind's the first thing to go. Let me get her out here. She'd love to see you, Mama.
Oh, don't disturb her, Dee Dee.
Mama. Oh, Mama, now you're going to mop
that up. Mama Pearl Burris is here. You remember Pearl, Mama. Pearl. Pearl! Oh, never mind. Well, what scared her off? No problem, I'll just put it on her bill. Sleigh bells ring. Are you listening?
Creative.
In the lane. Our park is pissing. Walking around, shooting at the Democrats. R.R., did you find them?
Find what, Diddy?
The grenades! God! Damn it, that's what I sent you in there for.
I forgot, but I found that old National Geographic we thought
we... Yeah, I'll bet. Useless. God, I'll do it myself. You stay here and look after the customers. Don't cross that line. God, if you were a cat, I'd have you fixed.
She shoots vegetarians too, so watch out.
Seen any UFOs lately?
Not any large ones. What happened to your finger?
Oh, Fresno regressed. I think he was just a little low on protein. I was wondering, do you sell mussels?
No, Dee says they're a waste of shelf space. Why have a guard dog if it can't bite? She'll be right back.
I gotta run, bye!
Bye, Dee Dee.
Christmas Phantom.
Well, I'm not showing my records to nobody.
Well, you might as well cooperate, Dee Dee, because if I have to come back, I'll bring a subpoena.
You think you're going to come in here and snoop in my bookkeeping? You better bring a Chinese dinner for six.
No, you make it damn hard for me to do my job.
You lay one finger on my filing cabinet and you'll be scratching your ass with a stump for the rest of your life.
Hey, Dee Dee, got a minute?
Maybe. That depends on what you're buying.
Now, I've been a good customer, you know that.
Yeah, the last thing you bought from me was a quarter's worth of BBs for that dim kid of yours.
Hey, he never had any problems till he ate all that plant food. Did he? You seen Hank Bumiller around?
Well, you know what, Ike? I was in such a rush to get to work this morning that I didn't have time to check the gutters.
That ain't funny, Didi. I talked to Bertha. I don't find Hank, it's gonna be a blue Christmas for a whole lot of folks.
Well, boo, hoo, hoo. I repeat, are you here to buy anything?
I'll be back for that, but I gotta go find Hank right now.
Well, it looks like Bertha's parking her car right across the street. Why don't you go ask her?
Adios, amigos.
Yeah, well, you better find Hank U. Miller or it'll be via con Dios. Good King, what's his name, went down. DDs use weapons. If we can't kill it, it's immortal. Well, hello, Dottie. Well, it's usually bad news when you call. Now, what's the matter? Is your plane late or what? What do you mean you're not coming? Oh, great. Why? Oh, hell. He's always had that, Dottie. Well, don't they have any antifungal cream out in California? Well, you still gotta come get Mom. No. I had her last Christmas. Yeah, I know you had her for Easter, Dottie. She still got egg dye in her hair and under her nails and God knows where else. We can't even take her to church. Yeah, well, I got a Christmas wish for you too, Dottie. Yeah, well, I hope Santa Claus cracks down your chin. God, it's hell being a twin.
Got a minute?
Well, come on in and have a cup of coffee, Pickles. I'm never too busy to chat with you.
Well, I thought you might be frazzled from the last minute rush.
Well, business is always brisk with the Phantom on the loose. You be sure to thank Stanley for me.
I hope to God the cops don't catch him.
Sheriff Givens couldn't catch a cold in the Klondike.
Well, Dee Dee, the reason I'm here is I wanted to know if you had any more of those burglar alarms on sale.
Sold my last one yesterday. Now, Bertha, are you having a problem with prowlers?
No, I just want something to wake me up when my worthless husband comes sneaking in late at night.
Has Hank been out tomcatting again?
I tell you, Dee Dee, it's so hard to hold up when the whole town knows he's as useless as ashtrays in hell.
Don't get me going. Our R's been on a wandering binge lately. You know, Bertha, I often wonder how it is that such well-brought-up gals like me and you could have married so bad.
It's a mystery.
Our art of drinking's only getting worse. He wanders off so much, I thought I'd better find out something about safe sex.
Oh, Dee Dee, I swear.
Imagine how depressed I got when I found out that's what we've been doing all along.
But I guess some things are better left unknown.
Amen, hallelujah.
Was that Ike Thompson I saw leaving just now?
Yeah, there's another one as useless as titties on a boar hog. Look, back to your Hank problem. I can order that burglar alarm for you.
No, that's all right, Dee Dee. I'll just do what I've always done.
What's that?
I'll just unscrew all the light bulbs and move all the furniture around.
Pickles. But we sure knew what we were doing back in high school when we voted you the class whip.
Well, sometimes you have to laugh to keep from crying. I better get going. It's going to take me a while to move that sofa. Merry Christmas, Dee Dee.
Merry Christmas, Bertha. Try not to strain your back. Just hear that ring, ring, ring-a-ling, jing, jing, jing-a-ling, jing.
cousin.
Okay, folks, we're back with Leonard's Let the Stops Out radio shopping spree. Now, folks, I haven't sold anything in weeks. I'm so desperate, I'll take hot checks. Where's your Christmas spirit? We've got great merchandise here. Come on now, give me a call.
Trying to kill these blue jays.
You don't give up on them blue jays, do you, Pearl?
They're so noisy. They got my banty rooster upset. He's got my hens so nervous they stopped laying. I'm losing egg money hand over fist. Pull up this chair, Stanley. I want to talk to you.
What is it, Pearl?
Stanley, I'm worried. There was a white mule in my dream last night.
Well, that ain't the sign of death, is it, Pearl?
No, that's a white horse. White mule is usually nothing more than car trouble. I'd appreciate it if you take a look under the hood of that Pontiac before you go.
Sure, I'd be glad to. Say, you know what I dreamed about? Do you remember that little weenie dog you had that could spell?
Oh, Doc the Dashhound. We got him from Petey Fisk. Of course, that was before we knew he was a cat hater.
I ain't never seen nothing like it. You just say the word cat, and that dog would go hog wild.
Oh, it got so bad we couldn't even say cat. We had to spell it, and he still went crazy.
That dog could spell cat.
We had a spelling dog.
Whatever happened to that dog, Pearl?
Doc, old Mildred Jean Perkins cat killed it.
What was the name of that cat?
Itty Bitty.
Itty
goddamn bitty. Now, who in the hell would name a cat that size itty bitty?
Oh, that brain-damaged child of theirs, Randy. That boy wasn't right, but they let him name that cat.
Well, how did itty bitty kill Doc?
Well, he just kind of rolled over on his back there across the street and lured old Doc right under the wheels of a Lone Star beer truck.
Damn, that's a shame to lose a good dog like that. That could spell.
Well, it was a shame you didn't have your taxidermy license then. You could have stuffed old Doc for us. That's the only way to have an animal, stuffed and hanging on a wall, take it down, dust it once a month.
It don't keep you up at night.
You're so lucky to have a skill. You need to leave, Tuna. Folks here will keep you looking back. You need to get out and tackle life. Use your gifts. Don't be like me and waste a skill.
Well, I never knew you had a skill, Pearl.
Oh, yes. I was a riveter during Houston during the war.
A riveter?
Japs never sank one of my ships. I put in so much overtime, I had to quit. All my fillings flew out. Stanley, your daddy come home?
Hell, Pearl, daddy ain't never home.
Well, you make sure mama's got a good Christmas.
Yeah, I got her a gift certificate down to Conoco. 5 free oil changes.
Well, staying out of trouble is Christmas gift enough. What do you want Santa Claus to bring you?
Bus ticket out of this black hole. Somewhere out west would be nice. Oh, and your friend Dixie DeBerry ain't making my life any easier.
How so?
Oh, she's making a fuss down at the little theater.
How's that going?
Shoot, nobody knows their lines. They're all fighting like cats in a bag. Joe Bob's blaming the Phantom, says he has everybody so upset they just can't think. And everybody's looking at me out of the corner of their eye. I tell you, Pearl, I have had it up to my ass with this sorry excuse of a town, and somebody's gonna pay.
Now, Stanley, don't lose your head.
Yeah, once my probation is over, I'm gonna sneak out there to that 4-H barn and paint the private parts on all the livestock. Let them hang a blue ribbon on that.
Do that.
And I got me a defanged rattlesnake that's gonna wind up in somebody's commode. I just haven't figured out who yet.
Well, that'll keep them regular.
And Sheriff Gibbons better stop following me like a bird dog. Damn, that man is bound and determined to catch me doing something.
Buford Gibbons. He's loopy, always has been. When he was a teenage boy, he went to bed at church camp.
No.
Oh, it's terrible. All the folks called him Rubber Sheets.
Rubber Sheets? Rubber Sheets Gibbons. I like the sound of that one. Rubber Sheets ain't gonna catch me doing diddly. Once this play's over, I'm gonna get even and get out of Dodge.
Oh my God, Stanley, I just had a revelation. If Dixie turns off the lights on Christmas Carol, you won't be able to finish your probation. She's just got to extend, that's all there is to it. And I forgot about the Phantom.
The Phantom?
Never mind, just go over and tell Dixie to get over here quick.
Hell, Pearl, Dixie ain't gonna listen to me. I'm a fella.
Just tell her it's a red alert. Go on, scat.
What the hell?
Hello? Is Sheriff Gibbons there? Put him on. Hello, Sheriff Gibbons. This is Pearl Burris. I want to report a theft. Well, 4 of my Rhode Island Reds were missing. I woke up this morning, they were gone. Do you suppose it was the work of the Phantom? You ought to drive by here more often. I'm a taxpayer. Those hens are my livelihood. You don't have time. I see. Well, I suppose you'd find time if the Phantom stole all your rubber sheets.
Back again. And you hold still, you little...
Pearl, why'd you send that slobbering hippie over to my house?
Dixie, don't distract me. This marble's got that Blue Jay's name on it. Nose hair off.
Now, Pearl, you are going about this all wrong. You
got to think like a bird if you want to kill one single.
Well, I've never heard of anybody singing to a blue jay.
Yeah, well, you damn sure ain't killed one neither.
Well, I hope they like the Andrews sisters.
There he is, sing, bro.
Down in the meadow in near the baby pole swam three little fishes and the mama fish too. Swim, said the mama fish, swim if you can. And they swam and they swam right over the dam.
Nearly got it.
Well, he'll get the word out.
Maybe you should sing something a little more contemporary.
Dixie!
Damn, Pearl, don't scare me like that. My heart can't take it.
Dixie, I'm sorry, but I just remembered you can't shut the lights off on a Christmas carol.
Maybe.
My nephew Stanley's got to be in that darn fool play.
Sit down, Pearl.
It'll just ruin Christmas if he doesn't get off probation. And Rubber Sheets is watching him like a hawk. One little slip up and he's a goner.
Now, I'd like to help you, Pearl, but I can't. Boy, if I let that little theater off their light bill, every light bill in town would go unpaid.
Now, I know
that's
that.
Revenue, Pearl. That's how we pay for things like stop signs and do not litter signs. And if that money runs out with the traffic gets snarled, the litter will pile up till you're just knee-deep in garbage and hot rodders, and then your insurance bills will go sky high, sky goddamn high.
I know that,
filth
but...
and disrespect-free crime, Pearl, which leads to gambling and the mafia, and the next thing you know, we'll have paramutual betting, liquor by the drink, parallel parking on Sundays. We won't be able to park for the goddamn whiskey bottles, and before he can say stat, the communists will be coming across the Rio Grande and end the civilization as we know it.
But all I'm
no,
asking...
No, Pearl. No buts. Stanley wants to get off probation. He can... He can drag his worthless butt to the welfare office and lick stamps for me, but I'm not turning my hometown over to Fidel Castro, and that's that.
Don't sit on the apple tree, anyone else but me, anyone else but me, anyone else but me. You dirty bird, you.
You know, Pearl, maybe he'd like a little Lionel Richie.
Dixie!
Damn, Pearl, he did it again!
Dixie, we're in trouble, we're in big, big trouble. Mimi Bird's been babbling. She told Dee Dee that we're the Phantom.
She has to shut up. She has to shut up right now. We'll all be wearing striped pajamas. This is all your fault, Pearl. I told you Mimi'd be the first one to crack. She nearly got us caught back in 52.
Now I'm warning you, you better just calm down,
don't
old lady.
Don't you stick that finger in my face.
Be sitting through I know karate. Cell ball.
I know karate.
Rubber sheet. Sit down quick, Dixon. Sit down. Wave out. Dixie, I think we're safe. Who's going to listen to an old woman like Mimi Bird with cake coloring in her hair?
Yeah, but the heat will be on now. We won't be able to be the Phantom anymore, and it's always been my favorite part of Christmas. I guess our party's over.
Our bubbles burst.
It's our last walk.
End of the line.
Adios, amigo.
Sayonara.
22, skidoo.
Good night, Irene. Good night, Irene. I'll see you in.
Give me the slingshot.
Oh, there is a rose in Jackson.
Ah! Bingo! Never knew what hit him.
Good shot, Dixie girl. We'll save him and have Stanley stuff him You know, Dixie, I've been thinking. It's not like the Christmas phantom to up and disappear just because one old lady with food coloring in her hair and one foot in the grave starts rambling.
You know, it might look suspicious at that.
Well, if the phantom's down to his last prank, I think it ought to be a doozy.
Well, I haven't seen that look in your eyes since you snatched the toupee off the faith healer in Wichita Falls.
He said he could heal the sick. He couldn't even grow hair. Now, Dixie, we've got to put our thinking cap on. Only the best yard will do. She's had it coming for 15 years.
Sing, girl, sing.
And talk about your Clementine and sing of Rosalie. Let's go, Texas.
KKK broadcasting live from the Tuna High School Gymnasium, where the social event of the Christmas season is underway.
Yes, folks, in a few minutes we'll all know the winner of the OKKK Christmas Yard Display Contest, and the tension is mounting.
It is.
Will Vera Orphan's family claimed 15 wins in a row in spite of her disastrous experience tonight due to the Christmas phantom?
Or will Dee Dee Snavely claim first place despite retina damage to two of the judges?
Through Dark Horse entry, good surprise. And now the moment of truth has arrived as Thurston will announce this year's winner.
You'll have to read it, Arliss. Hell, my hands won't stop shaking.
God almighty, give me that. And the winner of the OKKK Christmas Yard Display Contest and the non-stop weekend in Laredo goes to... I need a good one and hell in bed for all I want for Christmas.
Thank you so much. Well, I just don't know what to say.
Well, I do. We want to thank our boyfriends who inspired the entire display.
That's right. So muchas gracias, Donnie and Danny.
Kenny Ray, Garland, Preston, Duke, Clayton, and Dwayne, and Randy. What's going on over there?
Well, it looks like Vera Carp is fainted. Isn't that just like her at our big moment?
Y'all leave her alone. She's going to be hell to deal with when she comes to.
I want to say something right now. You know, there are times in life when everything can start to get to you. Well, I know that for those of us in the food service business, there are days when the grill is smoking, the ice machine is spitting cubes at you, and the poppy seeds are falling off the bun. And you can start to question whether or not Tuna has enough to offer aspiring career girls like us. But then something like this comes out of the blue. Well, I tell you, it encourages me so much, I just want to go back to school to get my GED.
Well, I'm grateful, I really am, but I'm not going that far.
And we want to recognize the other finalists.
That's right, we do, and someone tell that to Vera when she comes too. Now that that's over, this girl's ready to rock and roll.
Great, so we'll see everybody at the OKKK Christmas party later tonight.
That's right, and if Dixie cuts off the lights, we'll just start early. Yeah. Helen, is that Sheriff Gibbons over there putting a ticket on your Mitsubishi?
It sure is.
You get away from that truck, rubber sheets.
Hey, you put a ticket on my pickup truck, and I'll slip something extra into your chili dog the next time you come in. Okay, bye.
Oh, history.
You hit the music, I'll get the grill.
Have broken Beer Cart's stranglehold on the trophy. But it seems they had some help from the Christmas Phantom who struck the cart yard in a big way.
He did.
It seems when the judges arrived at the cart yard earlier this evening, someone had put boxer shorts on the shepherds, the wise men and Joseph, and the Virgin Mary was wearing an ERA button.
They did. That's probably what stampeded those sheep.
They're still missing.
They are.
But if anyone finds those sheep, you can leave a message for Vera Clark at the clinic where she is recovering in the trauma unit.
Visiting hours just started.
So go down there and get in line.
Tasty Cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you? Oh, hi, Charlene. Hang on. Okay, shoot. Okay, that's one double cheeseburger with chili in the works, one large fries, one large DP, one large fried pie, one grilled cheese sandwich, grilled in margarine, not butter, stir in the bread, hold the mayo, and one large diet DP. You know, Joe Bob would be a lot less temperamental if he'd get off that diet. Well, I'm just trying to help. God, you are sensitive. I need one Wimpy Cheese Delight and one Sweat Hog Special with natural gas.
Oh, my God, Helen, we have a crisis.
What now?
I was so nervous about the contest, I forgot to thaw out the hamburger meat. If we have a rush, Vernon will can me.
Calm down. I got my hair dryer back there in my bag. Oh. Just use that to thaw it out.
Good idea. Where would I be without you?
Unemployed. And you better hurry up with that meat. Joe Bob's gonna have a fit if we're late with his supper.
Joe Bob needs to take a powder.
And you know what? I've got some Pain Ender PM out in my pickup truck. I think I'll put a couple into his diet DP just to calm him down.
Great idea. I'll watch the front. Taste Cream, I need a speaking. What can I do you for? Yes, Charlene, I'll remember to trim Joe Bob's bread. Yes, I'll remember to hold the mayo. Have I ever forgotten your large fry pie, Charlene? Goodbye.
Hey, Anita.
Oh, hey, Farley, how are you doing?
I'm good. Congratulations.
Thank you. You coming to the party later?
Well, we'd love to, but we're a little short on time. What's so funny?
Nothing. God, you little people are Reggie. What can I do you for?
Give me two baby burgers and one medium fry.
You sure are hungry today.
No, I got Phoebe with me out in the truck. We're going to split the fries.
Oh, yeah, there she is. I can just see the top of her head. She sure can wrap that hair.
Well, she wouldn't be 4 feet tall without it.
Hey, Phoebe, Merry Christmas.
Well, she can't see you, the seat's too low. But I'll tell her you said hi. How long that food gonna take?
I'll have it for you in a jiffy.
Well, thanks, you big old corn-fed thing, you.
Julio, get off of Helen's hood. Sit on your own hood. Hector, you can't park there. You're not handicapped. Yet.
Hey, Anita.
Oh, hey, Penny. I hope you didn't bring that coyote with you again.
Well, Fresno's only half, and he hardly ever buys.
What can I do you for?
I came by to see if you have any leftover lettuce for Paula.
No, listen, Petey, I can't give you any leftover lettuce. Vernon don't want me throwing anything away. He finds out I've been giving leftover lettuce to a lizard, I'm in deep stuff.
Well, Paul ain't just any old lizard. She's a Mexican iguana with special dietary needs.
Iguana. Oh, God. Joe Bob Lipsy did a whole play about them once. Lots of nasty stuff about underwear salesmen. I didn't understand half of what they said.
Sounds weird.
It was weird. This whole town thinks you're weird.
Well, what do you expect from a place that has an elk hunting season and no elk?
Well, you got that right. There's not an elk within 1,000 miles of here. Look, Petey, I can let you have some romaine that's about gone, but I can't let you have that leaf lettuce. We're running low.
Thanks anyway, Anita, but Paula has a bad reaction to romaine. Last time I gave her romaine, she bit me right between the eyes.
Will you get out of here and take that four-legged handbag with you?
Well, I never.
Well, okay, wait a minute. I don't suppose anybody's going to be eating salad on Christmas Day. Merry Christmas, Petey.
You too, Anita. Paula says thanks.
Yeah, right. Oh, God, the meat.
How may I help you? Oh, hi. I need a flop one cheesy greasy, let it bleed.
Okie dokie, tell Aunt Pearl Merry Christmas.
Miss Burris, Anita says Merry Christmas. You too. Do you want shaved ice or cubed ice with that? Okay. Well, thank you. Well, what a nice thing for you to say. Yes, we're real proud that we won, but I guess we really have to thank the Phantom, though. Hello? She hung up on me.
Helen! Have you seen my wife, Helen?
Well, not yet, Leonard, but you know what? That looks like her Land Rover pulling up right now.
Helen, I'd appreciate it if you not tell her you've seen me.
Well, you should have thought twice before you married a wilderness stout, Leonard. Pasty cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you? Oh, hi, Charlene.
This is fun.
Yes, I know that was large diet DP for Joe Bob. It's going to be about 10 minutes. We had a small problem. I don't want to talk about it.
Yeah.
Yes, I know that Joe Bob is hypoglycemic. Well, you tell Joe Bob he sets foot in Anita's kitchen, he'll be hypoglycemic with a limp. God, I hate this job. How's that meat coming?
Oh, my God.
Has Charlene called my order in?
Anita, Joe Bob is here for his order.
I'm hypoglycemic. I need food.
Sit down, Joe Bob. You look weak.
I haven't eaten in 3.5 hours.
Now, you sit down. Sit down there. Here, you have a big old jumbo diet DP.
Thanks.
Can I get you something to munch on while you wait?
Anything. Peanuts, breadcrumbs, dip a napkin in ketchup. I need nutrition.
Well, here, you munch on these chips, okay?
That'll help. Oh, God, they're stale.
Well, I just serve them. I don't preserve them. Oh, they are stale.
Yeah, about as stale as this town. You have no idea how I've suffered. I haven't had this many problems since that old white production of Raisin in the Sun.
I love that one. It was so funny.
An hour from now, I'm looking at an opening with a lead who can't find his teeth.
How about a boom?
Stanley Buemel slouches through the street, seem like some thug.
Big hunk?
Goes to Christmas past, dips snuff, carries a spit cup. Anita keeps belching.
Open wide for Chunky.
I ask the costumist for scarves, I get bandanas. Bandanas! I'm doing a Christmas carol, not Rio Bravo. I'm coming in there.
How about pickled egg? Mm-mm.
I am bigger than this town.
Well, I heard that.
You know what I am?
What?
I'm a professional.
Oh, yeah.
I've been to Waco. I've been working the professional theater district from Corpus to Flagstaff. And if Dixie D. Berry thinks she can just cut off my lights, she can kiss my rosy pink butt.
You need to get that food out here. I'm about to get sick. Tasty cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you?
Oh, hi.
Yeah, but he's eating. Well, you know how he is when you get near his trough. Hang on. Joe Bob, it's for you. Now, it's Charlene. She sounds real freaked out, so you be nice to her.
What is it, Fifth Wheel? Charlene, I can't understand you. Why are you crying? You're afraid of the dark. She what? She what? She... That old horn frog cut off my lights.
Bob, I'm so sorry.
That's all right, Helen. There's only one thing I want from this town before I leave.
What?
My grilled cheese sandwich, and I'm going in there to get it.
Joe Bob, no.
Out of my way, Helen.
I can't.
I'm coming in there, bigger.
Joe Bob, don't. Anita throws things. Oh, I hate this job.
Get out of my kitchen, Joe Bob. Get out of my way,
Moose.
I'm warning you, Joe Bob. Ow! Damn! Ouch! Ow! Ow! Helen.
What?
Will you do me a favor?
What's that?
If I'm still in this town next Christmas, will you take me out somewhere and shoot me?
Well, I couldn't do that, Joe Bob. But I'll get one of my boyfriends to shoot you. They'd be glad to.
I need a nap.
Yeah, bye. Oh, break a leg. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Anita, are you okay?
Never better. Hey, Helen, honey. Get on over here. Where's our food?
It'll be just a sec. We had a small crisis.
Hell, how long does it take you to cook these baby burgers? What you have to do, go out there and kill that steer?
Now, listen, paperweight. We are having a bad day. Now, your food will be right out.
Well, I certainly hope so, because we're just about to waste away out here.
Tasty cream, Helen speaking. How may I help you?
Oh, I'm
Randy. No, no trouble at all. All the time in the world. You what? You have a present for me? Oh, Tuna! Now? No, we're not too busy. But you better come around back in case Vernon comes by. Boy, I'd hate to get canned on Christmas Eve. Oh, me too. Well, I'm headed that way. Bye. Anita, you need to wash the front for a minute.
Are you nuts? I'm up to my knockers and frozen patties back there, and you're gonna go disappear somewhere? Helen, there's no excuse for this.
Oh, yes, there is.
What?
Randy.
Go for it, girl. Tasty cream, I need a speaking. What can I do you for? No, Charlene. Oh, no, Charlene. It was his fault. He came into my kitchen. Oh, no, Charlene. He started it. Charlene, why don't you get yourself a real man? We're just so all tired of watching you bark up the wrong forest. Get off that horn, Shorty!
Hey, Anita.
Oh, hey, Garvin. Why don't you come in and take a load off?
Well, I'm on duty. I just came by to see if you need any more soda water.
Yeah, we're fine, Steph. You know, Garvin, I wish you came in cans. I'd pop your top every 5 seconds.
You cracked me up, Anita. You know that.
Go in the back and help me thaw out the hamburger meat.
Well, I'm on duty. Oh, I'll do you a favor just this once.
Well, you do me one now, I'll do you one later.
You crack me up, Anita, you know that?
You use Helen's hair dryer to thaw the meat, darling. I need a speaking. What can I do you for? Oh, hello, Vernon. No, nobody's drying their hair at work. I don't know. Clean out your ears. Tomorrow, what about tomorrow? I am not working on Christmas Day. Who's going to want to eat out on Christmas Day? Your family. Well, they can all go over to your house and fill up on bologna. You can't fire me, Vernon, because I quit, and so does Helen. Well, why don't you kiss me where I can't reach?
What's going on?
This is the worst Christmas of my life.
What's wrong?
Vernon just fired me.
He what?
Well, actually, I quit because he wanted to stay open on Christmas Day. And Kenny Ray's off in Fort Worth with my truck.
Well, you can borrow my Mitsubishi anytime you want.
No, I can't. Last time Daddy caught me driving your Japanese truck, he boxed my ears. You know he fought in the Philippines. We couldn't even eat rice growing up. Now I got no truck, no boyfriend, no job.
Well, you still have me, and I'll work double shifts till you get back on your feet.
Helen.
No, it's no trouble at all. What a friend's for. Oh, we'll have to cut back, but we'll get by. And before long, you'll be able to pay the back rent, overdue bills, for that stolen pickup truck. Life will return to normal.
Helen.
Now, I don't want to hear. As long as I have a job, you have a home. Just say that over and over in your mind. As long as Helen has a job, I have a home.
Helen,
what?
You quit too.
I did.
Yes.
I did.
Oh no.
Anita, where are you gonna live?
Oh.
Thank you.
Fresno sick. Stay, Fresno. Now, Fresno, I know that you're half coyote and you're not used to being stampeded by hostile sheep. But if you bite me one more time, you're going to be singing the call of the wild. And you sheep, stay over there by the gate and don't stampede the coyote. This natural enemy thing is about to kill me. I'm down to my last good arm and leg. One more injury and we'll all starve to death. And Paula, I know that iguanas are prone to depression, but you're going to end up with a zipper and a snap if you don't lighten up. You all ought to be ashamed of yourselves. Where's your Christmas spirit? Hey, stay calm, stay calm, stay calm. Just stay calm. Let me look for the star. Ow. Well, there it is. There it is, Fresno. Look at it. Shining like the very first Christmas. Well, we were all a part of it. The shepherds were watching their flock of sheep by night when they saw that star. Apparently, there was a coyote problem. And Joseph and Mary found no room in the inn, but the innkeeper said they could stay in the stable, and that's where the baby was born, in amongst the cattle and the sheep and the iguanas. Well, look at it shine. You know that when the light left that star, there wasn't even anybody here to see. It's like looking at eternity, shining down on everything. Peace on earth, goodwill to everybody. I never get tired of hearing that. Well, that's something to wish for. Now come on, Paula and Fresno, let's go inside. You sheep, just stay over there and just stay calm. We all need our rest. Tomorrow is Christmas Day.
La 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 la. 199, 200,
in, Stanley. You're just in time for a toddy.
Well, I got all the time in the world, Pearl. Dixie cut off the lights at the community theater before I could finish my probation. You should see the look on Rubber Sheet's face.
Well, Stanley, I've got tidings of great joy for you. I cut a deal with Dixie. She said you could go down to the office and lick stamps on next month's bills to finish your probation. Well, I just did it for you. You're free to go.
Well, you didn't have to do that, Pearl.
Well, I wanted to. I'm just glad we're a small town. One more stamp would have gagged me. Look here. Here's a ticket to, one-way bus ticket to Albuquerque. Little something extra in there. You can thank your Uncle Henry for that spending money.
Why do you want me to go to Albuquerque, Pearl?
Well, they say they have a lot of wildlife out there. You'll always have something to stuff.
Hell, Pearl, you think of everything. I wonder what Mama's gonna say.
Well, don't you worry about Mama. If ever Bertha had to let go of something, it was you. Now you best hurry up. That bus won't wait on you.
I don't know how to thank you, Pearl.
Just don't ever look back.
Ain't you gonna kiss me goodbye?
No, I've licked so many stamps, I'm afraid I'd stick to you.
Hell, Pearl, you're crazy.
No, I'm not. Now, don't say that.
KK in Tuna, Texas. We're going to be going off the air early tonight so we can have our annual Christmas party here at the station. Now, everybody's invited to come as long as you don't bring your kids. We don't want any punch poured down our transmitters like last year. Now, we'd like to take this time to thank our sponsors here at radio station OKKK. Clifford's Piano and Organ Shop over in Sand City. Clifford's wants you to know it's never too late to get your hands on a good organ. So come on down to Clifford's, talk it over, and remember, at Clifford's, they will hold your organ until Christmas. Now, this is Arliss Droopy on radio station OKKK, signing off.
Knock, knock.
Well, come on in.
Am I the first one here?
Yep.
No matter how I try to make an entrance at a party, I'm always the first one through the door. I guess it's my destiny.
Well, at least you get to see all the appetizers and jello molds before folks eat them up.
Well, here's a pretty one. I wonder what she used to make the hooves.
You know, I kind of wonder where everybody is.
Well, I know Dee Dee said she wasn't showing up because the party interfered with her TV schedule.
She won't miss Gunsmoke.
And Thurston went over to Sand City. Wolko had a special on bubble lights.
And I suppose Leonard is still at the clinic.
Well, nobody's seen Leonard since Dee Dee told the world about him and that red-headed bank clerk. We hear Reba track him all the way to Amarillo.
Amarillo?
Reba can track a flea across concrete.
And she's a good shot when she finds what she's tracking, too.
Deadly aim.
I don't suppose we should expect either of them.
So is your husband coming by?
I haven't even seen Hank today. He's not very good at parties, and besides, Hank never was one for Christmas. Some of my worst memories of Hank are at Christmas time.
Well, Trudy could be the same way. She'd get meaner than hell right around Pearl Harbor Day, and it could go all the way to St. Patty's.
How long were you and Trudy married?
14 years.
That's a long time.
Seemed like 50. Now, if we're going to be talking about Trudy, I got to have a snort. You want one?
Oh, I really shouldn't, thank you.
Just a little snort in your punch?
It's against my religion.
Well, who's going to tell on you?
I really mustn't.
Well, if you don't want any.
Well, maybe one, just one little, one little one. That's Maxie Bovine's punch, I recognize that.
Mmm, bitter.
Mmm, better. What were we talking about?
About how awful Christmas can be.
Oh, yes, and it was worse when the kids were younger. Hank would get drunk and put all the toys together backwards. He'd get mad and then leave. The worst Christmas, though, was the Christmas that Hank got out of prison and didn't bother to tell anybody. I spent all Christmas Eve on a bus to Huntsville, and him not even there. And then turning around and going back the next day with 2 9-year-olds fighting every inch of the way. And Jody was just a baby. And then in Big Springs at a rest stop, Stanley talked Charlene into climbing into one of the empty luggage compartments, and he locked her in. She screamed bloody murder for 10 minutes till I could find the bus driver to let her out. I'd have whooped them both had it not been Christmas. And it was cold.
Well, the worst Christmas I can remember was the year that Trudy up and moved the trailer house while I was at work.
Why?
Oh, hell, she was mad. She wanted an archery set for Christmas, and I told her no.
An archery set? Why did she want that?
I have no idea, but hell, our insurance was high enough because of her driving. I wasn't about to get her a bow and arrow.
And she moved the trailer?
Well, she moved it all the way to New Mexico. Just flat out ruined my Christmas.
I can imagine watching your home disappear across state lines like that.
You want another snort?
I really shouldn't, thank you.
Just a little whiff in your punch?
I mustn't.
A little dab will do you.
I really shouldn't.
Well, if you don't want anything.
Well, maybe just one little one. Well, a little larger than that. Oh, Arliss.
And one for yours truly.
It's a shame that nobody else came to this party.
It is, it is. I was hoping to get a little dancing in.
Oh, dancing? Is there going to be dancing? I probably shouldn't even be here. In my church, we don't dance.
You want another snort?
Why not? I remember when we were in high school, Vera and I snuck over to Sand City and went to a dance. Well, I let that slip to Mama one Saturday while we were cleaning house, and Mama whooped me with a vacuum cleaner hose.
God almighty.
Well, Mama's got a way of breaking your bad habits. I can't even shampoo rugs without thinking of that time. I haven't been dancing since. I don't even know how.
Well, I'll show you.
Oh, hush, Arliss. We're Baptist.
So am I, but do you know when I go out of town on vacation or conventions and stuff, I tell everybody I'm a Methodist and I have one. That time we raised so much hell in Houston, I claim to be an Episcopalian.
Episcopalian? What was that like?
Well, I really don't remember too much about it, but time I came to, I was back in Tuna feeling like a baptism.
Oh, Arliss, Episcopalian, I wouldn't have the nerve to do that even for one evening. Oh, Arliss, it must be something, being a big celebrity like you. You must have plenty of women after you.
You would think so, wouldn't you? But, well, the truth is, ever since Trudy and I split the sheets, I've kept every Saturday night open, and every Saturday night I end up playing Risk with Thurston or going over to Sand City with him for Chinese food.
No. A well-known broadcaster like you?
It don't figure, does it? But you know, I think that the glare of the spotlight scares a lot of women off. And well, Trudy said a lot of mean things after the divorce, especially when the judge awarded me the trailer house. But hell, that trailer been in my family for years.
It's practically an heirloom. The whole town knows that.
But on the other hand, look at you, Bertha. Well, I mean, sure, you've got your kids, but Hank, God almighty, well, it makes me just mad as hell to know that that worthless husband of yours has had such a loyal and well-fed gal like you waiting on him at home, and he hasn't taken you dancing not once.
I told you, Arliss, we're Baptists.
I don't care. Even Baptists ought to sin a little once in a while. That's what church is for. It's a place you go to feel better after you've done some sin. It ought to make you mad as hell if that worthless husband of yours is not taking you dancing.
It's beginning to the more I think about it.
You want another snort? Poor. Shh. If I was Hank, I would take you dancing twice a week.
Oh, Arliss, I spilled my drink. I really should be
Stop.
Going.
Don't budge an inch.
What?
It's the way those radio tube lights bounce off your boots.
Oh, is that just in my hair?
Shh.
very running. Good.
Oh, my
boughs of holly, la 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 la. 'Tis the season to be jolly, la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la. Fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la, heedless of war.